What is up, everybody? SmackedWookie here, and today I'm installing CachyOS, replacing Bazzite as my Linux distro of choice. I'm not going to sit here and dump on Bazzite. I'm sure it's fine. I just ran into some problems like games not launching that I couldn't get past. I'm new to Linux. I'm not claiming to be an expert or anything. I just want to play PC games with the minimum amount of troubleshooting. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you see. Leave a comment below with any advice or if you have any questions, and don't forget about subscribing. I'd really appreciate it. Today, I'm going to do a clean install of CachyOS, create a new partition, and get CachyOS ready for gaming. What else needs to get installed after the OS is up and running? Which games work out of the box, and which games require some finagling? I've already booted into the CachyOS USB environment. This here is the CachyOS Hello window. You can click on any of the buttons here and it will open the associated webpage in Firefox. At minimum, check out the CachyOS README and Wiki page for instructions and more information before installing CachyOS, unless you'd like to be difficult like me. Click on Launch Installer to start the CachyOS installation procedure. The first thing that I was asked for was selecting which bootloader to use. Bootloaders let you choose which operating system you want to load, which is helpful if you're dual booting Linux and Windows or multiple Linux distros. They each have their own pros and cons and ways to modify the settings. I'm not going to get into the details here. I'll have a link to the bootloader wiki page in the description. I'm just going to select the default bootloader option. The next two screens are pretty straightforward. They're just localization options. This next screen is a little more complicated. This is where I choose which drive and partition to install CachyOS. It may look different depending on if there's already another OS or data on that drive. I'm just going to select Replace and click Next. Here, I'm going to select the desktop type. I'm just going to use the default Plasma desktop. I can install other types of desktops later if I want to. After that, I can add additional packages. This is where I can add more desktops to switch to after the OS installation has completed. I'm going to skip this for now. And here is where I create my login. Notice how it's not forcing me to use an email address? I always name my computers after Gundam Wing mobile suits. I'm going to name this one Toggies. Finally, I will review my settings, and once everything looks good, I'll click on Install and let it run. The install process will reach out to the internet and grab the latest operating system files. The installation time will vary on your internet speed and your computer specs. The good thing about this is I won't need to run another update once the install is completed. This took me about 9 minutes. Here's what it looks like in 9 seconds. CachyOS has completed its installation. I'm here at the welcome screen. Unlike Bazzite, there's nothing installed but the OS. No Steam, no Heroic Games Launcher, Proton and Wine aren't included yet. To install these programs, click on apps/tweaks and then install gaming packages. I selected option 1, Cachy Extra V3. I'm not sure what the difference is between the two. This installation took a total of 2 minutes. And as you can see, Steam, Lutris, and Heroic Games Launcher are installed. Even though the CachyOS installation reaches out to the internet to download the latest packages, I'll still check for updates again just in case. And everything is up to date. I need to split this drive into two partitions, one for CachyOS and one for games. I'm doing this in case I need to reinstall CachyOS. It'll stay on that partition, and the second partition will be dedicated for games. This is also my NVMe drive, so it has faster read-write speeds than the other drives I have installed on this computer, which is connected using a SATA cable. I'll use Gparted to split the partitions. It wasn't installed with CachyOS, so I'll open the package installer, click on Repo, and search for Gparted. Click on Install, and then OK. After a quick install, I'll open Gparted. the disk I want to edit is already selected in the drop-down menu on the top right. Right-click on the partition I want to resize and click on Resize Move. From the new menu, I can use the bar slider to resize my OS partition. CachyOS doesn't require a lot of space. It has an incredibly small footprint, but you still need to have some room for future applications and updates. I don't anticipate installing a lot of other programs on this computer, just games, so I'll go with the 60GB partition. After I clicked OK, we see a new partition appear. Right-click on that, click on New, and then tell Gparted how much space you want to give it. I just made the new partition the amount of space that's available on the disk. Give it a label, unlike me, and you'll see why in a minute. And then click Add. Make sure everything looks good. Then click on Edit, apply all changes, and then apply again. Next, I'm going to log into Steam. I have a second drive installed on my computer, which has some games on it. I want to add those games to my library. I need to mount the drive in the Dolphin File Explorer and then restart Steam. Once Steam has loaded up again, click on the Steam icon in the top left-hand corner, click on Settings, and then go to Storage. Click on the drop-down menu and then Add Drive. On the next window, click on the drop-down menu and select the second drive, and then Add. This will automatically add games that Steam found on that drive into your library. I also need to add the new partition into Steam, so I'll do the same thing. Click on Steam, Settings, Storage, and Add Drive. Click on Drive. As you can see, my new drive name is a string of random characters. This is because I didn't make a label when I created this partition. I need to create a new folder for Steam games to go into. But because of the way Gparted runs, you won't be able to do that easily. So here's what you need to do. Go to Steam Settings, and then Storage, and then Add a new drive. Notice that I cannot select the root of the drive, and I can't create a new folder. Right-click wherever there's empty space in Dolphin, and then click on Open as Administrator. We need to change permissions so that your user account can read and write data to this drive. Otherwise, you will not be able to install games. Right-click on the drive on the left side, then go to Properties, then click on Permissions. Change Owner, Group, and Others to Can View and Modify Content. Close out this window. From here, you should be able to create the folder under the context of your user account, not admin. Test that by creating a folder to store your games. After you create the folder, select it in Steam. I'm going to add Final Fantasy VII Rebirth and Red Dead Redemption 2, along with Cyberpunk and Heroic Games Launcher. Next, I'm going to import Epic and Galaxy games into Heroic Game Launcher. At this point, I've already logged into both accounts. I just need to select the game, click on Import Game, and find the folder the game is installed on. I'll repeat these steps for Final Fantasy VII Remake Intergrade, Death Stranding, and Witcher 2 and Witcher 3. That'll do it for today's video. So far, I've installed CachyOS, split my main drive into two partitions, one for the operating system and the other one for games, installed the necessary game launchers and drivers, and got Steam and Heroic Game Launcher set up. Next up, I'm going to start testing some games and see which ones work without any additional configuration and which ones I need to finagle a little bit. Let me know in the comments if you see any games you want me to test. I'd love to hear from you. I appreciate that you made it this far in the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel if you want to see more of my journey into Linux. Later.